हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी डायरेक्ट ऑनलाइन स्टार्टर एंड स्टेटर रेजिस्टेंस स्टार्टर। व्हाट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ स्टार्टर? टू लिमिट द एक्सेसिव फ्लो ऑफ करंट। सो लेट अस डिस्कस वन बाय वन डायरेक्ट ऑनलाइन स्टार्टर। दिस इज द स्कीमेटिक डायग्राम ऑफ डायरेक्ट ऑनलाइन स्टार्टर। डायरेक्ट ऑनलाइन स्टार्टर मेथड इज द कॉमन मेथड ऑफ स्टार्टिंग ऑफ केज इंडक्शन मोटर। द मोटर इज कनेक्टेड थ्रू स्टार्टर across the full supply voltage. The direct online starter method as shown in this figure. It consists of coil operated contactor, that means the C. It controlled by start and stop push button as shown in this figure. This figure shows the overall arrangement of various component in direct online starter. NO contact is the normally open and NC contact is the normally closed contact. At starting position, the NO is push on, that means the these stop and start button is push for the fraction of second, due to the which coil gets energized and attract the contactor. So the stator directly gets supply. The additional contact provides ensure that as long as supply is on, the coil gets supply and keep the contactor is in on position, that means start position. When the NC normally closes its press, the coil circuit gets open, due to the which coil is gets de-energized and motor gets switch off from the supply. Under overload condition, current draw by the motor increases, due to which there is an excessive heat produces, which increases the temperature beyond the limit. Under overload condition, at that time the current increases, that means the temperature is also increases. So the at that time thermal relay gets open due to high temperature and protecting the motor from overload condition. So the button which may install in convenient place from the starter, the start button is held open by spring on pressing the start push button S1, this push button S1 and push button, and the contactor C is energized from the two line contactor, that means the L1 and these L1 and L2. The three main contacts M and auxiliary contact A are closed. The terminal, these terminal A and this terminal B are short circuited. The motor is then connected to the supply mains. This is the supply mains. The S1 button moves back under the spring action as soon as the pressure is released, and the coil remains energized through this A and this B. So the main contact M remains, these are the main contact M remains closed, and the motor continue to get supply. Therefore the contactor A, this capital A, is known as the hold on contact, and the stop button S2 is normally, this S2 is normally held the clothes by using the spring. If S2 button is pressed to stop the motor and the supply through the contactor coil is disconnected, that means de-energized, as the coil C is de-energized, and the main contacts M, these are the main contacts M and auxiliary contact capital A are open, and the supply to motor gets disconnected and the motor is stopped. Now let us discuss the stator resistance starter. So what is the stator resistance starter? This is the schematic diagram of stator resistance starter. Apply reduced voltage to starter of induction motor, and three resistances are added in series. These are the three resistances are added in series, with each phase of stator winding. Initially, the resistance are kept at maximum position in this circuit. Due to the large voltage gates drop across the resistance, so reduce the voltage gates applied to stator, which reduces the high starting current. So whenever the voltage applied at this side, and this is the reduced voltage, that means the voltage is decreases, at that time the starting current is increases. When the motor starts running, the resistance are gradually cut off from the stator circuit. When the resistance are removed from the stator circuit, that is the rheostat is in on position. The rated voltage gets applied to stator and the motor runs with the normal speed. Starter is simple in this starter is simple in construction and cheap. It can be used for both star and delta connected starter. But there are the large power loss due to the resistance. So this is there the disadvantages, because the power loss is occurred in this case because of the resistance. This is the overall operation of stator resistance starter. Thank you.